Busy news day here in the Fox 8 newsroom. We have a live look here at the stock market and the Dow at one stage this morning with the news of the president testing positive for COVID-19. The Dow was down about 400 points, but you can see things have settled out. Actually up in the green, the positive, up 12 points. All right, the NASDAQ still down 167, the S&P down about 12 and a half. But everything seems to be calming down on Wall Street. But what does it all mean? You see, when news broke of the president's COVID diagnosis, the market was looking pretty bleak this morning. Futures for the S&P 500 and the Dow dropped nearly 2%. But as you just saw, they seem to be slightly on the rebound now and leveling out. Alex Menassa from Szarka Financial is here to give us a little more insight as to how this all shakes out with the news. Alex, always a treat to see you here. How should we take all this news? It was a bumpy ride this morning. Now things are leveling out. What happened?
Well, hey there, Gabe. First of all, it's great to be here. Happy Friday to everybody. The answer to your question is the market was shocked. Okay, you know, the market reacts a lot like we do as individuals. It's a shock at first. You know, it's crazy news, and it takes a while to process the information. It takes a while to adjust, to think about it, and so as we've seen so many times in history, there's no surprise at all that we had an initial shock to it. I do think it's going to create a few changes. First of all, I think it's going to create a renewed focus on this whole COVID thing. There's a fatigue there. You kind of get tired of it. You start to think about other things, maybe forget about it a little bit. It's going to create a renewed focus on COVID. I think we may see some of the market trends return for a while that we were seeing in the summer. Technology doing a little bit better, the dollar getting into some trouble, that kind of thing.
Given that it drops so dramatically this morning and then bounces right back out, it starts to even out. What is the state of the American economy, and how should we compare what we have here with other countries around the globe?
Well, I'll tell you, I don't think this changes the overall dynamic that was already going on in the market. It's kind of a dichotomy of the good news, bad news, okay? The bad news is September and October typically are the worst months of the market, and it does tend to be volatile in the month before an election. That is certainly true. However, there's a lot of good news, too. Auto sales are looking good. Home sales have been fantastic. For anybody who's tried to sell their house, you know what I mean. And especially the fiscal stimulus. This whole thing, it seems to be pushing Congress toward coming up with a fiscal stimulus package. They're working hard. Hopefully they'll be able to come to an agreement, maybe even as soon as this weekend. I don't know if you saw, but they just announced that to have airlines hold off on all those furloughs because they may be coming up with a special package just for airlines. So all of that is good news. Also, we're closer than ever to a vaccine, hopefully in a few months. So, you know, all of that is good news as well.
Let's say over the next couple of months we get the vaccine and, you know, the airlines hold off on all of, you know, the furloughs and the layoffs and the markets, and we get the stimulus check too. I would think things are going to explode.
It very well could be. You know, history shows us that if you panic and move to cash at times like this, you're going to miss the rallies. That's just the way it is. So it doesn't mean that you shouldn't be careful, though. Anyone who's in that red zone a few years before retirement or after, have a checkup on your portfolio. Anyone's welcome to call us, and we'll look over the portfolio, give you some ideas. But in general, you know, the best thing to do is to just go find an orchard and pick some apples this weekend and enjoy the season.
I like that. Don't cash out. Don't take the cash and stuff it into your mattress. Just go buy some apples and just relax.
Go pick
simmer
apples.
Down. Everything's going to be okay. Alex, man, you look great. Really a treat to have you here on the Noon Hour once again. It's been a long time, my
great
friend.
Great talking to you. Thanks for having me.
Thanks for the advice, as always. You're going to save us some money. You're going to make us some money. We appreciate you, Alex. If you have financial questions or need more information on Szarka Financial Services, you can head over to our website, fox8.com, and click on Seen on TV. We all just need to simmer down a bit, right?